first song on our ears to see what is truth. I'm getting a little screech. Is it from my guitar or my voice? Okay, but it seems to be gone now. Shall we give it a go?
Yeah.
Franco, can I talk on the mic?
Yes.
We could use a little more of Franco's voice.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. That's good. That's good. That's good. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. The song is about to begin.
Second song.
Thank you. This is a song about the single life. It's an anti-nostalgic. It's called A Spy in the House of Style. It's about going to a party at the wear pad and no one talking to you. And it goes like this. Thank you.
as I fumble around for this, this is our one cover song of the evening, and it's by the Mountain Goats. If anyone has heard of the Mountain Goats, you should, if you haven't. This is a honeymoon song, and it's called Twin Human Highway Flares. And Glenn is going to start us off here. Shirly,
We're doing, we're putting on a show at Doc's Clock on Mission and 22nd on the 10th of November, and Bernie is going to be doing some of his songs, and then a guy named Carvel Wallace, who if any of you have seen him, you know how brilliant he is doing a set, and then we're going to play. And we're hoping that we can continue doing monthly shows at Doc's Clock. We're going to have Toy House and Therese Taylor on December 8th as well. And then we'll see like whether they'll let us keep doing it. So this song is this is ambitious. This is actually a song that we haven't done live as a band, but it's on the What Is Truth CD. And tonight it's going to be dedicated to Elliot Smith. It's called Ex-Supernova.
I'm just sitting here laying up. I just can't wait to get out.
Yeah.
back there if I may.
So, here we are, the 1st of November. We're approaching Thanksgiving, and this is a song about Thanksgiving.
See, look at her back there, sir.
This is a song about relatives getting together and biting each other's heads off over politics. And it's called You of All People.
Keep my hands steady.
One, two,
three, four, one. Thank you.
was written during when I worked at Green Apple Books, and we were trying to bring union representation to them, so. And Bob Dylan wrote kind of a crappy song in the 80s called Union Sundown, so I wrote this song called Union Sunrise. Am I correct?